.NET interactive notebooks are a new thing to me. Tune into this episode of MVP edition of Data Exposed to learn more. Hi, I'm Anna Hoffman, and welcome to this episode of Data Exposed MVP edition. Today, I'm joined by Rob. Rob, why don't you tell us a little bit about yourself?
Hi, my name's Rob Sewell. I'm lucky enough to be an MVP, and I'm a bloke that likes to spend his time either deep in code solving problems or stood on a stage doing presentations.
Well, we're happy to have you here, and today we're going to talk about PowerShell, and we're also going to talk about notebooks and something that I hadn't even heard of until you brought this idea to for this video. So why don't you tell us a little bit about why you like notebooks and how it relates to PowerShell?
So hopefully everybody knows about notebooks nowadays. And the number one reason why I think we should use notebooks is this precise problem. If we've got an editor of some sort, a client tool, and we connect to a database and we run a query of some sort, we've got our results. And that's brilliant. But if this was 3 o'clock in the morning and we were resolving an incident, we might have numerous queries open. Maybe at some point we'd get distracted and actually close one of these tabs. And the biggest problem when we close this tab, the results are gone. They're of absolutely no use to us when we do a wash-up meeting or to refer to later in the incident. So this is why I love notebooks, because notebooks give us executable code and they get to save the results. So quite often when I have an incident or I'm asked a question, we've got a problem with this, perhaps the first thing I'll do is open a notebook. And if we make that a bit smaller, then I'll say, well, okay, here's some text about what's happening. Today's incident is this, something happened. Or maybe the first thing I want to do is check my instances are up and running. You're going to work. Yes, there we go. Look. So, right, have I got some SQL? Yes, I've got some SQL instances. They're up and running. So, you know, perhaps the other thing I want to check is my database is there. Does it exist? Yes, there we go. It exists. And I could carry on going through this, doing my troubleshooting, seeing what is happening. And the beauty of it is if I just save this and we'll save it in Ctemp. Don't save your instant notebooks in Ctemp. But we'll call it, no, it doesn't. There we go. This is what happens at 3 o'clock in the morning.
Third time's a charm.
You never know. Ooh. Don't save it in Ctemp. But now I've got my incident. If I close that and it goes, then no worries, because I can just type c/temp. Look at this, did it. Go to my incident. There is the code that I wrote, the documentation I wrote, and all the results. So that is, in 30 seconds, just why I think we should use notebooks. Number one reason.
Awesome. Yeah, thanks, Robin. I also think notebooks are super powerful, but now I'm looking at your screen and I'm seeing something I've never seen before, and that's you're using a .NET PowerShell kernel. Can you tell me what is that and how did you get that set up?
Ah, so how do we get that set up? That brings me to something even more cool. So let's have a look at this. What I'm going to do is show you GitHub. And in GitHub, we've got a notebook. And this is showing you that you can actually display your notebooks within GitHub. They render here. You can put them in gists. So when my friends ask me questions about how do I do this thing with PowerShell, I'll create a notebook because they can look at it quickly in a browser and see what it is that I'm saying. And then they could take it down and run it on their own machine and actually play with it and change things and make it work. So how do we get a .NET interactive? Click on this link. It's going to take you to this blog post by Maria from the .NET team, and there are a number of steps to follow there. I'm not going to go through them because you're just going to have to follow them. That's how we get them. Now, I'm using Azure Data Studio to show the editing experience. There are other ways of doing it. To achieve, to be able to edit .NET Interactive Notebooks in Azure Data Studio, you just need to do one little thing. So you need to have the latest Azure Data Studio, stable or insiders, and then click on the cog and then settings. And if you search here for kernel, it's going to come up with these two options. And by default, this will not be ticked. So you'll need to tick this one. The second thing you need to do, press F1. And if we type notebook, we get the option to create a new notebook. And you can see we think, great, we'll just change the kernel to .NET. So there's a little flip here. Change the kernel to Spark or one of the other ones. And then, ta-da, as if by magic. Awesome. Now we can pick our .NET PowerShell, which is absolutely brilliant. Now, this is true .NET core compatible PowerShell. It's going to run PowerShell 7 on whatever machine that you, whatever operating system that you choose to run it on. It's going to have the same experience.
Awesome. So we've seen how to set these up, this new thing of .NET notebooks that I hadn't seen before. Looks like multiple sort of languages are supported there. Now, if we kind of bring it back in, like, how does this relate to SQL? I mean, obviously, you can do a lot with SQL and with PowerShell and with .NET and with Azure Data Studio, but can you kind of bring it all together for us?
Okay, so let me show you. What I would do is make use of my GitHub repository. And for example, we've talked about how we could use this for incident response. We talked about maybe demonstrating things with, you know, maybe with your friends, maybe your open source project, whatever else. What about repeatable tasks that we need to do again and again? So we get asked, who has got permissions to this database, to this instance, to this whatever? Well, what about if we could just, doesn't matter what's behind there, we can give this notebook to a normal user with the right permissions, and then we could run it, and it's going to do a whole lot of magic and provide us with, on another screen, everybody's favorite way of displaying data, Excel, with nice color-coded output ready for our users. So all I've done there is run some PowerShell code that's been written to bring out all of the permissions for an instance, color-coded, ready for a business user to make use of.
Wow, that's really cool. I have never seen something like that before. You know, are you going to share all out this GitHub so that our viewers can kind of play around with? Seems like you got a lot of stuff in here.
Everything is here. So if we come back from this page, this is my Jupyter Notebook repository. And within that, you can see SQL DBA with a beard. Can you guess
that's
why?
You.
That's me. And it's Jupyter Notebooks. And then in this notebooks folder, we've got .NET notebooks. And we've got what I call not .NET notebooks, which is your typical before .NET Azure Data Studio notebooks. And everything is there. Please use them. Take them, make them better, and tell me what you do.
Awesome. This has been really cool. I've seen a lot of new stuff today. I hope the viewers have as well. I think they probably have. We'll put a link to Rob's GitHub in the description. Thanks so much for being here with us today, Rob. It's been a great time.
Thank you so much for having me. I absolutely love sharing this. And to be able to teach you something new after all the things you taught me, it's brilliant.
Yeah, awesome. So thanks for our viewers for watching this video. If you like this video, please like this video, subscribe to our channel, and tune into our next episode of Data Exposed.